Hello, Kitty. In the last video, we talked about how using a new medium we're not yet comfortable with can push us to solve problems, problems that give us a reason to be creative. Let me share you my learning curve in using colored pencils to illustrate a big comic book for the first time. I went through 5 stages of preparations before I started to get the hang of it. First of all, I needed to know which colored pencils I should get. My big book was going to be over 100 pages long. So with that in mind, I knew I had to gather art materials that I can easily restock in case I run out. In my past 3 comic books, I used wet media in paint tubes. And each paint tube can go a long way, especially if it's high in pigment. But with dry media, things turn to dust much faster. I know you know this as much, Kitty. If you've ever used a pencil, any pencil, then you know how quickly the tip gets dull and how often you have to sharpen it. And each time you sharpen it, your pencil is considerably shorter. So that was the first constraint, or first requirement that I had to consider, which actually made the decision quite obvious to me. Because all I had to do was find the pencil that was easily available to restock at any time. Now, I did use a bunch of other dry media, like graphite, charcoal, wax oil pastel, and chalk pencils for a few chapters in my book, but the bulk of the pages are illustrated using colored pencils. I expected to run out of certain colors fairly quickly, so I knew it had to be Caran d'Ache Luminance, because I can buy the same specific color more than once, and there's a physical store that sells them not far from my studio. Now, the second stage of preparation was to test the pencils. I wasn't yet wedded to the idea of buying the pencils until I had first-hand experience in using them on paper. Since this brand of colored pencils are sold separately, the store had a set of them available just for testing. So they gave me this little piece of paper to scribble on. I had to make sure I test out a few essential techniques to give me a good representation of its capabilities and output. To do that, I first made a simple swatch with the color code next to it. Then I made a simple gradient with it, coloring with a hard to a light hand pressure. Then I tried drawing a few things that will show up in my comic book panels, but in a miniature version of it. Lastly, I tried a simple blend of colors to see its effect on the paper. It looked pretty good to me, so I bought a handful of them to play with back in the studio. Now we enter the third stage of the preparations, which is to figure out which color combinations to use for the different chapters in my big book. I tried mix-matching with other brands of colored pencils that I had, but it opened a whole new set of options that was just too much to consider. It suddenly felt like I'm treading in the middle of an ocean with no clear sense of direction. I needed to keep it simple again, so I stuck with my first constraint, which is to use a brand of colored pencils that I can easily restock per piece. That means constraining myself to choose from the set of colors that Caran d'Ache has at the store. That turned out pretty well, because I discovered I can get Caran d'Ache Neo colors to use for my comic book border panels. These are wax oil pastels, but they're available in a set of colors that use identical pigments or match very close to the pigments used in the colored pencils. So this gives me a way to draw thick lines with just one stroke. Now we've reached the fourth stage of the preparations, which is to create a few colored thumbnails. Doing this helped me figure out the best color assignments for certain visual elements. I needed different palettes to show the different seasons in the book, so this is why I ended up with 4 palettes. But then I also had to figure out a way to color my characters consistently, because using a different color in another chapter to color my little wolf would be a little confusing to the reader. This was true in the case of the animal characters, since they don't wear clothing and they have very similar shape and build. So I made sure the way I color the animal characters were the same throughout the book. I discovered it's okay to vary the color of their outlines, but as long as I kept using the same pigment to color them in, it becomes easy to distinguish the characters from each other. Alright, Those four stages actually took me a month to prepare. And now we're ready for a little warm-up chapter. In my case, I had one chapter in my big book that was going to be rendered using an assortment of graphite pencils. It's the only chapter that's in monochrome. So there was no other perfect place to start but here. As with any beginner artist, it's always useful to start sketching with one color, so that you develop a good eye for applying tonal values and proper contrast. Going through this monochrome chapter was also a good way to warm up my drawing hand, that by the time I finished rendering all the pages of the chapter, I was ready to dive in with the colored pencils. I couldn't wait to start seeing colors. I still had some ways to learn when it came to color blending techniques and line art execution using colored pencils, but I was able to figure them out along the way. With every new page I colored in my big book, it felt like going to class to learn a new lesson. Alright, that got a little longer than usual. I'll try to keep it short next time. That's all for now. I'll talk to you later.